Welcome to the session on the topic set theory under the course discrete mathematical structures at second year of information technology engineering semester 1. At the end of this session, students will be able to apply principles of set theory to solve problems involving sets. So earlier we have learned the concepts of set theory in terms of the different types of sets along with its notations. Then we have learnt about set operations, namely union, intersection, complement, so on and so forth. So in this session, we are going to solve problems based on the operations on sets. So here comes the first example. If A1 is equal to 1, 2, 3, A2 is equal to 1, 2, 3, and A3 is equal to 1, 2, 3, then show that A1, A2 and A3 are mutually disjoint. Now, in this type of question, first of all, we know that what are mutually disjoint sets. We have seen a property by which you can say that the given sets are mutually disjoint. And the property says, if two sets, let us say A and B, are mutually disjoint, then they satisfy the condition A intersection B, that is, A intersection B must be equal to phi the empty set. So we'll apply the same property here and try to judge whether the given sets are mutually disjoint. So if you observe, if I try to take A1 intersection A2, okay, and we observe that it results into, there are no common elements between A1 and A2, so it is equal to phi. Similarly, if I take the intersection between other two pairs like A2 intersection A3, you will observe that it also results into phi. Similarly, the third pair A1 intersection A3 also results into intersection giving phi as the answer. So we have shown that all three intersections results into an empty set phi, hence proved, that is, the given sets are mutually disjoint. So that is how we show the given any number of sets and you have been asked to prove that they are mutually disjoint, then you have to simply take intersection between every possible pair of the sets and show that it is equal to phi the empty set. Okay, so with this we move on to the second example. Show that A subset of B is equivalent to A intersection B is equal to A. Now, what does this mean? We have been given the condition that A is a subset of B, and then we have to prove that it is equivalent to saying that if you take intersection between A and B, it must be same as A itself. Okay, so to prove such identities or the given properties, we'll write the solution in this way. Okay, we know that, or we may note that for any x, where x is an element, from set A, we write it as x belongs to A, conditional x belongs to B is equivalent to saying x belongs to A, and that is conjunction with x belongs to B by conditional x belongs to A. Okay, and it simply follows from, so we say which follows from the identity that we use is P conditional Q is equivalent to P conjunction Q by conditional P. Okay. Now, A subset of B is equivalent to all those elements X such that X belongs to A conditional X belongs to B, while A intersection B is equal to A is equivalent to saying that set of elements X such that X belongs to A and X belongs to B by conditional X belongs to A. Okay. So if you observe the solution once again, we say for any X, you may note down the given property as if X belongs to A, it simply implies X belongs to B, and it is equivalent saying that X belongs to A and X belongs to B is biconditional X belongs to A. And we have assumed this from the property that P conditional Q is equivalent to P and Q biconditional P. And hence we have shown that if A is a subset of B, it is equivalently, if you take intersection of A and B, it simply results into the same set A itself. Okay. So with this, we move on to the next example. Example 3. If S equal to A, B, P, Q, and Q is equal to A, P, T, then find S union Q and S intersection Q. So we can directly apply these operations and find out that the solution is S union Q results into the common elements as well as remaining elements from the set. So we get A, B, P, Q and T. So it is simply the common as well as uncommon elements coming from S and Q. Similarly, S intersection Q results into the common elements, and that is only A, comma, P. So this is the solution. So this way, we have solved certain examples and you have got an idea how to go about solving problems based on sets. So here is an assignment for all of you. Given A equal to 2, 3, 4, B equal to 1, 2 and C equal to 4, 5, 6, find A plus B, B plus C, A plus B plus C and A plus B plus B plus C, where plus denotes the Boolean sum operator. Okay, so you have to apply the Boolean sum and find out the answers for the given sets.
थैंक यू।